Hey there, everybody, and welcome back to another art class with your art teacher, Mr. Young. For today, if you're wondering what we are going to do, here's a little clue on the first page. But for today, we are going to learn about the Disney legend, Mary Blair. After that, we will have a little activity that we will be doing. And then after that, I'm going to show you how you can turn in your artworks to me in our Google Classroom. So let's go ahead and learn about this artist. Her name is Mary Blair, but she was born Mary Brown Robinson, and she was born on October 21st, 1911. So she was born a long time ago, and she was an American artist, animator, and designer. And she is most well known for being a Disney legend, meaning she is part of the Disney Hall of Fame for being one of the most famous artists and designers who worked for Walt Disney. And she created concept art for films including Alice in Wonderland, Peter Pan, Song of the South, and Cinderella. She has also designed attractions in Disneyland, including It's a Small World. And we'll get to see that in the next slides here. So here are some of her works. Here's another image of her. And can anyone tell what the top concept art is from? That's right, that is from the movie Cinderella. She created some concept art for the animated movie Cinderella. And then can anyone guess the name of this? Yes, this is from Peter Pan, and here is Captain Hook. And lastly, can anyone guess the art of the bottom one? Yes, this is art from Alice in Wonderland. And so she created all of these artworks for Disney before they created the movies. They would create some concept art, some of the ideas they want to put in the movie before they actually draw it out for the animated movie. And so she was in charge of a lot of these projects with Walt Disney. And here are some of her designs she did for It's a Small World, which is one of the rides that you can take in Disneyland. And so if you've gone to Disneyland or Disney World before, you might have seen this ride. It's called It's a Small World. If you don't know, in the next slide, we're going to actually take a virtual boat tour through this attraction that Mary Blair designed.
Friendship to everyone. There's a man if you want, and the earth to come.
I hope you enjoyed that little boat ride, our virtual boat ride, and it's a Small World attraction at Disneyland. You can see from this video that we went all over the world from Disneyland in Paris, Disneyland in Tokyo, and Disneyland in Hong Kong, and then also Disneyland here in America. And in all of these attractions, each of these It's a Small World sets are all designed by Mary Blair, the artist that we learned today. And here are some more of her artworks. So you can see here, she likes to create all these different buildings and these castles, as we call them, using all these different shapes, bright colors, and patterns. So you can see these are going to be our inspiration for our project today. So if you want to look closely, you can pause the video and just look closely at these artworks and see the different kinds of shapes and patterns and colors that she used in these castle artworks. You can also notice the different kinds of roofs that she added. She also added different kinds of doorways or paths and also different kinds of window shapes if you wanted to add windows. Now, after looking at her artworks, we're going to create our own castles, and there's two different ways you can create them. We have option one over here, where you will use paper and something to color with. Or if you have some extra supplies at home, you can do option two, which you would need paper, colored paper, scissors, a glue stick, and some kind of marker or pen to create this kind of castle. So depending on what you have at home, you can do one that's more simple, just a drawing with paper and some coloring materials. Or if you have some extra supplies you'd like to use, like some of the construction paper or any kind of other colored paper you have, and then you can make this cut and paste type of castle over here. So before we begin and I show you how to create it, you can grab these supplies and you can also pause on this slide if you needed to look at these examples more closely. And over here are some of the castle references that I will use to create my castles. So you can see on this first side over here some of the different designs you can put on the inside of your castle. If you look at the last page over here, each of our castles is broken up into different squares or boxes, and inside of each of these boxes you'll have different kind of patterns on the inside. And you can also see that here where we have different designs and colors on the inside of each box. So inside of the box again, you can create any of these designs that we have over here. I also have a second page of more designs over here. And lastly, on the tops of your castles, you'll add some kind of roofing or the tops of the castle, like this example. Or we have this more triangular roof with a flag on top. And then we have these rounder roofs if you like that. And then we have two different ones down here, one with a windmill and one that kind of looks like a staircase going up and down. So you can make your castle however you want. Here are just some references if you need something to copy off of. And I'll also post this in our assignment in Google Classroom. All right, so in this video, I'm going to show you how I created the first option using just a piece of paper and some coloring materials. So what I grabbed was just some markers that I had, but you can use any coloring materials that you have at home. And on the sheet of paper, I'm going to draw out with this black marker first, and I'm going to draw a straight line going horizontally, going side to side. After that, I'm going to create a short vertical line and create this box shape or this rectangle shape. After that, I'll make another rectangle shape a little bit taller. And my next rectangle is going to be even taller and even wider. So I'm going to make a really big rectangle in the middle or towards the middle. I have another rectangle shape next to that, and then a shorter one again on the side here. Doesn't have to be completely symmetrical or equal on both sides. And then once I have my rectangles, I'm going to add some details. I'm going to add the roofs. So you can see I added a triangle roof, a semicircle or a half circle roof. Here I am just going to divide my rectangle into smaller or skinnier rectangles, and again adding the roof on the top. Here maybe I want to do a different roof type, and I'm going to show you on this sheet of paper here just a different roofs that you can create. So I'm doing this curved one with a circle on the top, and I'll also add some little details, these curved lines on the inside. I'll add another triangle one with a flag on top. And then maybe I want this castle-like top on this one. And then finally at the bottom, the last roof, I'll add this windmill. Once I'm done with that, I'm going to divide my rectangles up into smaller squares. So you can see here, I'm dividing my long rectangles into smaller squares. And so I can put some more details inside each of these squares. All right, so here I'm going to reference off of some of my castle designs over here and create the same design on my castle drawing over here. Maybe for my next design, I want to do this one over here that I just pointed out, and I'll make another half circle or this curved line. And I'll create this other curved line, this arc, for like the doorway at the middle. So you can use my reference sheets as examples on what you can design on the inside of yours. Here next I might want to add some windows, so I'm adding these circle windows just like our example over here. And I'm going to continue on the rest of my squares and add in all of these designs. And it doesn't have to match all the way around. You might want to do something different for each one, and that's okay. Alright, I just fast forwarded a little bit, and now you can see I've added a lot more designs in each of my squares, and it's coming out really well, I think, because it looks a lot more detailed with all of these different patterns on the inside. And once you're done drawing out the details, you can go in with some colors, like I am here with the red color, and start filling out parts of your castle with these bright colors. Alright, I'm just going to fast forward a little bit more here, and you can see that I've colored in more of my castle here with all of these different colors. I just had some primary and secondary colors that I used to color this one. And you're going to color in your castle however you'd like. It could be different patterns. And once you are done coloring it in, make sure you take a photo of it. So you can see here that I am done with my castle. If you want to color it more or put some background details, you can do that. But all I'm looking for is that you created your castle and you use different colors, different shapes and patterns, and you use all these different geometric shapes too to design the layout of your castle. In this next part of the video, I'm going to show you how you can create a castle if you have some more supplies you want to use at home. Here's another way you can create it. Alright, now I'm going to show everyone how you can do option 2 of doing your castles. This includes some extra supplies, so if you don't have these, you don't have to do this one. Make sure you just do option 1. But if you do have some extra supplies, like some colored paper, some scissors, and a glue stick, you can do option 2 of creating our castle. So in this video, I'm just going to show you how I did it. So first, I grabbed my colored paper. I wanted to cut some squares out easily, so I put all of the papers together, and I used my scissors to then cut out one strip along the straight edge. So I cut as straight as I can along the edge of all the sheets of paper here. And so now I have this really long rectangle, but I'm going to cut them into squares. So I'm going to cut them into these small squares like this. And that's how you can cut a lot of squares easily with just about a few cuts. So you don't have to cut as many times to create all these little squares. After that, I'm going to take some of the squares, line them up evenly, and I'm going to cut them in half like this to create little triangles. Now that I have all these shapes, I have squares and triangles, I'm going to put them off on the side so I can paste them down on this white sheet of paper on the bottom here. Before I paste them down, I'm going to grab some of my shapes and I'm going to arrange them in a specific order that I want them in. So I'm just going to arrange it however I'd like, and you can do the same with whatever color paper that you have to arrange it in the order that you want it in. Once I have my shapes arranged in the way I'd like them, I'm going to start gluing them down evenly on the piece of paper. So I have the first row down here at the bottom of the page, a row of four squares going across. And I'm going to glue down all of the other ones right on top so they're more evenly stacked. And I'm just going to fast forward a little bit here, and you will see now all of my squares are more lined up evenly like I have it here. Some of my rows are a little bit taller or shorter than others, and that's okay. After I'm done with these squares, I'm going to paste down these triangles on the tops of my squares to add the rooftop. Now, if you want different shape roofs, like I did earlier when I drew them out, you can cut out different shape roofs. But for this, I just used the triangle roofs for these ones. Now I'm going to reference off my reference sheet here and add some lines on the inside of each of my squares using a black marker, or you can use a black pen or some other material that you want to use to draw these designs with. And I'm going to draw a design on each of these squares, as you can see I'm doing here. And I'm going to switch it up for each of these squares, or you can have a repeat pattern if you want to. I'm done with the inside of all of the squares. I'm going to go back onto the rooftop and add some details. Maybe over here, I want to add that windmill on the top of this roof and little flags on the top of the other ones over here, and maybe a circle on the last roof. And then if you have some coloring materials, you can go in and then color those in. And if you want to use some different colors to color inside of your castle, inside of each of the squares, you can do that too. All right, now you can see here my finished castle that I use some colored paper for and some glue and scissors to make this happen. Again, this is option two that you can do, but all you need to do is do one of the options, either option one or option two for your castle. And once you are done, make sure you take a photo of it. And now I'm going to show you how you can turn it into me. So here I'm going to show you how you can turn it in your artwork to our Google Classroom with attaching a photo. First, before you turn it in our Google Classroom here, you're going to go to the bottom of your computer screen, and you're going to click on the bottom left corner, and you're going to type in a search button, camera. And then you will find the camera app on your Chromebook or computer. So mine might look different from yours, but make sure you find your camera app. If you're able to take a video with your Chromebook or your laptop, you should have this camera app. So once you find it, you're going to click on it. And then it's going to pop up your camera just like it is for me right here. And you should have this camera button that's for you to take a photo. So you're going to take your artwork, you're going to hold it up in front of the camera. You can have your face in it if you want. And you're going to click take a photo, pressing this take photo button. Once you've taken the photo, you're going to exit out of here and you're going to go into the Google Classroom and you're going to go under classwork and you're going to go down on week six and click on Mary Blair Castles. Once you clicked on that, you should see a button that says View Assignment. And so since I still haven't posted this yet, I'm going to show you on this other example over here. So when you click on assignment, it should say view assignment at the bottom. You're going to click on view assignment, and you're going to, so I'm just going to show you on this right side where it says your work, you're going to click on the plus sign that says add or create. You're going to click down here that says file with the paperclip. And then you're going to upload from your computer. So you're going to click upload and then the blue button that says browse. And then you're going to pull up on whichever file that you've saved it on. So usually it's under the pictures folder. And then under pictures, it should be under your camera roll. And then here is my picture that I just took with my castle art on it. And you're going to click open. Once you click on that, your picture should be uploaded here and you can click turn in. Now there's another way you can take a photo that you might find easier. Instead of going on the camera app and everything, you can just click on plus add or create. And then instead of file, you will click on this blue button that says docs. What that will do is create a Google document for you. And once it creates one, you're going to be taken to this next page on a different tab of your Google Doc. Once you have that, you're going to go at the top of the page and click insert. From there, click on image, and you're going to go all the way at the bottom here and click on camera. That actually opens up the camera just for you to take a photo and upload it directly to the Google Doc. So I can have it here next to me, and I'll take a photo clicking this capture button. Once I have my image like it is here, I'm going to click insert, and you can make this bigger if you'd like so you can, I can see your artwork clearly. And once you have that, if you go back to the previous tab, it should be already there. And then once you have that Google Doc, you can click turn in. So that is two ways you can submit it to me. If you have any problems, make sure you email me your work. If you need my email, I'm going to have it posted on my stream here. All right. So hopefully that was helpful for everyone. If you have any further questions, make sure you email me or you can send me private comments. Now, if you don't know how to send a private comment, you can either take a comment down here on the stream page, or if you want it to be private, you can go under the assignment and then, let me show you on this example over here. So again, under the assignment, when you view the assignment, you can ask any questions down here. You'll type out your question, and then you're going to send it to me clicking this post button. And then I can see any of your comments that you have just for me over here. I hope this was all useful. Make sure you finish up your project by next week and you turn it into me. And I hope you'll have a fun time with this Mary Blair Castles project, and I hope to see your work soon.